What up, guys? Compa Giovanni, welcome back to the Requintazo podcast, donde hablo de cosas que me ayudan a mejorar como persona y negociante. This podcast is for those músicos who, I know there's going to be músicos who I can never change their mind, because obviously there's going to be people like that. So for those músicos who think that you need a label to in order to make it, I'm going to side with you, all right? So we know this is proven, because people who are signed, they're making it, and they're doing money, and they're living by music. So my question for you is, why aren't you doing shit? Why are you waiting for the label? Like, I'm going to be honest with you right now. Labels don't just get any músico. They don't just get any grupo. If we look at the history of músicos, of grupos, these grupos, they get signed by label once they already have a following. They already start making it. For example, like, I don't really do a whole bunch of research on them, but I'm going to base it on músicos that I know. Like, for example, Tercer Elemento, before they were signed, they were already starting a following. They were already filling out venues. People were listening to their stuff online. They didn't have a label. A label's a business. So their goal is to invest in an artist, but they want to make sure that that investment comes back in the form of money. They're not just going to invest a whole bunch of money into random artists, because they won't make money like that. So they have to, it's like business. I don't know if you ever watched the show Shark Tank. In Shark Tank, all these different businesses, they go to these investors asking for money. But these investors aren't going to invest in random products. They're going to invest in products that are already shown to prove that they could sell. So if these businesses, they're already making sales and stuff, then yeah, that investor is going to invest, because they know they're going to get their money back and more. So the same thing with disqueras, dude. They're not going to invest in random músicos who don't have no following, who ain't doing shit right now. They're going to invest in grupos who are actually putting in the work, who are actually getting views, who are actually doing something to make their following, to get a following. So if you ain't doing shit right now, why the fuck should a disquera get you? That's my point. What are you doing in order to make these disqueras go for you? If your answer is nothing, then you're just wasting your time, dude. No disquera's gonna want you like that. But if your dream is actually to make it big and have a whole bunch of fans and get known and get signed by your favorite label, then fucking put in the work, dude. Fucking make videos, go in the studio, record songs. And again, all these things don't have to be high quality. Like, another example, people think that they need all these songs recorded in studios and stuff in order to make it, but you don't, dude. If you see some of the biggest artists, they got known before they were signed by releasing a popular song. De repente sacan una canción, it doesn't even have to be original, and it gets a whole bunch of views on YouTube, and bam, they're on their way. And if you see these videos, they're not high quality, they're not studio quality. Most of these videos que andan pegando ahorita, they're videos en vivo. Like, you don't have to have a studio to record at. Some people even make it just recording on their phone. As long as your talent is there, that's all that matters. Quality doesn't matter. Fuck quality. So that's my question to you. If that's really your dream, dude, if you don't... Okay, fuck my ideas. Fuck that you don't need a label. I'm agreeing with you in this one. If that's really your dream, dude, then do something about it. Alright, I'm going to end this podcast right here. Please share this podcast, and I'll see you in the next video.